Hello guys, welcome to the current series of JMeter tutorial for beginners. In this video, we're going to understand the concept of thread groups. So what are thread groups and how we can work with them? So the first question, what are thread groups? As the name says, thread, right? This can be referred as virtual user, right? This means that thread groups means user group. Now, what does this user group do? They simulate the, or you can say that execute the scenario, right? The same thing that we usually do in our browser, these would be doing the same thing, right? So any number of users, it can be one single user as well, it can be 100 users as well. This is what we decide, right? Now over here in JMeter, let's just switch over to JMeter now. So over here now, what we have to do is that right click over the thread test plan, then go to add, then you can see the option of threads, right? So here choose the option thread group, and here in thread group you can see that there are a lot of options. For example, what are the number of threads, the ramp up period, the loop count, right? Now it is asking us for a lot of things. Now the thing is that whenever we have a default thread group added, it specifies few defaults. So what are those defaults? The number of users to be 1, ramp up period to be 1, right? And loop count to be 1. Now what are these things? Users is clear by the text itself. Ramp up period. What is ramp up period? Ramp up period is the time taken by the users to start, right? And it is always in seconds. So 1 second means one user would be starting in 1 second. Now the next thing is loop count. How many times the same scenario needs to be executed? For example, if we specified the loop count as 10, so the same thing would be executed 10 times for the same user. If it is infinite, then it will keep on executing it, right? Now there are other options as well. What are those options? If you notice them clearly, these are some options, right? What are these options? What does these specify? Continue, start next thread loop, stop test now. So these are the things when you execute a test, right? When you execute some scenario and some of the samples fail, in that case, what you want to do, what action should be taken? For example, if you click on continue, it will keep on executing the test, right? Now the problem in that case is that if you try to execute the test and suppose one of the steps is failing, if you keep on continuing the test, then what is the sense of testing the flow, right? In many flows, you need not to go forward if the one of the things in between are failing. In that case, you can simply choose one of these options, that is start next thread loop. This will start the next loop if there is another loop specified, otherwise it will stop the test. Stop thread, this will stop the current user completely. Stop test, this will stop the whole test execution, right? And stop test now, this will stop the test immediately without even allowing other users to complete their execution, right? This is done. Now let us do one thing. Let us have some things added over here. So what I'll do, I'll simply add up some data, add sampler, and we'll be adding 2 samplers, right? So add up 2 samplers. Now here I'll be keeping the first one as Google Home, right? The request is pretty simple, https://www.google.com, right? The port number is 443. So this is done. The next one is Rediff Home, or MSN Home, right? So MSN has also the protocol https. then www.msn.com/443port number/en-in. Right? Now this is done. So over here we have two things. Now let us just add a listener so that we can see the results as well. Now I would be choosing view results tree listener. Now by the default things, if I execute it, you can see that the only two samples would be executed and they are executed only once, right? These are the default settings. Now what I'll do, I'll specify 10 users, right? And now we would want to see the user number over here as well. So what I'll do, I'll simply make use of function helper dialog. We have already learnt about it, how we can use it. So here, what we would be doing is, we would be simply retrieving something which is beneficial for us, that is thread number. Right? So thread num over here, generate and copy, this is done. Just specify it over here. So in the end, hyphen this. Right? Just copy paste this stuff and you can provide it anywhere you would want to. So I'll specify it here. Right? Now this is done. Now let us just save this test plan as well, and we would be saving this test plan as thread groups, right? So that it should not ask us again and again. Now I can execute this test. So over here you can see that this has got executed. We had 10 users. Let me just flush out all the results and run this once again. And you can see that Google Home 1, Google Home 2, Google Home 4, Google Home 5, Google Home 6, 3 took some say more time. You can see that 749 milliseconds, other took lesser time. So all the 10 requests are there, Google and MSN, all the 10 requests are here, and you can see that everything is executing well, right? Now over here, now what we would be doing is, we would be adding up something over here. If you notice something, all the things got executed within 1 second. Now what I would do, I would simply add up some time. So say we have 5 users and the ramp up period is 10 seconds. This means that every user would arrive in 2 seconds, right? Let us just run this. 1 second, 2 second, one user has executed, second user, third user, fourth user, fifth user, sixth user. So over here, you can see that in the 10 seconds mark, it started the 10 users, right? Sorry, 5 users, right? And everything is executing serially now. Now, if I say increase this ramp up period time, so instead of this, I would specify 50 seconds, right? So in the 40 seconds mark, it would be executing them. Why 40 seconds mark? Why not 50 seconds mark? The thing is that first user is starting immediately. So next user would be starting after a time gap of 10 seconds, right? 50 divided by 5. Okay. So over here, you can see that the tests are executing. At 30 seconds mark, fourth user would start. And 40 seconds mark, fifth user would start. Okay, so you can see that fourth user is done executing, and in the next 5 seconds, the fifth user would also be done executing, right? So this is done. You can see that the test is executed, right? Now I told you about the error as well. So let us just do one thing. Let us add another sampler. This would be a failing sample, and say I'll keep it here. Sorry, yeah, and I'll name this as failing request, right? Now I have not provided anything here, so this is pretty sure that it would be failing anyhow, right? So if I run this, as you can see that I have not changed the settings. So after every 10 seconds, all the 3 requests would be executed. As per the logic, maybe the MSN Home should not be executed because we are facing an issue just before that request, right? Now you can see that failing request is executed every time, and after that MSN Home is also being executed. Now let me just stop this execution. Now over here, if I specify this thing, that is stop thread, what this would do is this won't execute MSN home because failing request is failing, right? So if I execute my test, and let me just stop the execution first, let us just change the ramp up period to 10 seconds. That would be a better option, otherwise it would take a lot of time. Okay, so over here now you can see that the requests are executing and you cannot see any MSN home request. The reason is that failing request is failing and it is not allowing the next request to be executed, right? So this is how you can manage your thread trips and this is how you can manage your test cases, right? Thank you.